नमस्कार। इन लास्ट टू वीडियोस वी हैव बीन टॉकिंग अबाउट द फंडामेंटल प्रिंसिपल ऑफ आयुर्वेदा दैट इज प्रकृति। इन फर्स्ट वीडियो वी हैव सीन द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ थ्री बेसिक प्रकृतिज, वात प्रकृति, पित्त प्रकृति एंड कफ प्रकृति। इन अनदर वीडियो वी हैव सीन व्हाट इज एप्रोप्रिएट डाइट, दैट मीन्स व्हाट इज सुइटेबल, व्हाट इज पथ्य एंड अपथ्य फॉर द पीपल हैविंग वात प्रकृति। Now in this video, I am going to share you the appropriate and suitable regimen food for the people having Pitta Prakriti. Friends, the regimen I am sharing in this video is equally effective and applicable to the people having Pitta Dominant Prakriti. That means the people having Pitta Vata Prakriti also, as well as the people having Pitta Kapha Prakriti also. That means Pitta would be their dominant Prakriti associated either with Vat or Kapha type of Prakriti. I'm sure by now you are very clear and you have identified what your exact Prakriti is, and that is why you are in this video. If you haven't still identified your Prakriti, I would again advise you to go to the link in the description section and answer a small questionnaire so that you can identify what your exact Prakriti is. Based on that, the exact and suitable regimen will be shared to you by email on your email ID. So now let's come to the appropriate and suitable regimen for the people having Pitta Prakriti. Friends, as you are aware, the people with Pitta Prakriti are the ones having firebrand personality. They are the outspoken people, most aggravated, agitated, easily kind of people, firebrand, and what you say, the angry young men kind of people. They are the ones whose pith has to be kept at balanced level. Otherwise, they are prone to the diseases like digestive disorders, ulcers, acidity, then graying of hair, baldness, premature graying of hair, hair falling, then skin diseases, inflammatory diseases. These are some of the diseases which are likely to happen to the person with pith prakriti. In order to keep the pith dosa balanced, there are certain things which the people with pith prakriti should always keep in their mind. Firstly, they should avoid all the food stuff which is salty, too much spicy and sour. Also, they should avoid consumption of tea, coffee, alcohol, tobacco, etc. because these are the food stuff which will exaggerate Pitta Dosha. Now friends, let me share you the exact regimen, the Pathya Apathya for Pitta Prakriti. If you follow this, I am sure you will be able to remain healthy without exaggerating your Pitta Dosha, and your Pitta Dosha will remain balanced and you will be able to enjoy a vibrant pink health. So as far as cereals are concerned, wheat, rice, ragi and barley, these are the compatible cereals for a person with Pitta Prakriti, but they should avoid millet, bajra. In beans, black-eyed beans, moong, tuwer, kidney beans, these are the compatible or suitable beans, but they should avoid black gram and horse gram, or they should keep a minimum intake of these beans. In milk and milk products, cow's milk as well as buffalo's milk are compatible for a person with Pitta Prakriti. They can easily digest butter as well as cow's ghee, but they should keep minimum intake of curd, cheese and sour buttermilk. In vegetables, drumstick, bitter gourd, pumpkin, cabbage, potato, lady's finger, beetroot, cucumber, spinach, cauliflower, bottle gourd, cluster bean, green flat beans, French beans, carrot, these are some of the vegetables which are suitable. At the same time, they should keep minimum intake as far as radish, brinjal, onion and garlic is concerned. In spices, they should consume clove, coriander, pepper, sindhav namak, dill seeds, turmeric and fennel seeds. And they should avoid consumption of ginger, mustard, cinnamon, red chilies, asafoetida, fenugreek and palm leaves. In fruits, there is a long list which is suitable for a person with Pitta Prakriti. Ripe mango, apple, बनाना, ग्रेप्स, कोकोनट, आमला, पोमोग्रेनेट, कस्टर्ड एप्पल, ग्वावा, जैक फ्रूट, डेट्स, आलमंड, स्वीट मेलन, वाटरमेलन, जामुन, चीकू, फिग, बट दे शुड अवॉइड रॉ मैंगो, पपया, ऑरेंज, पाइनएप्पल, कैश्यू, स्ट्रॉबेरी एंड चेरी. इन ऑयल्स सीसेम ऑयल एंड कॉर्न ऑयल आर मोस्ट सुइटेबल, बट दे शुड अवॉइड मस्टर्ड ऑयल एंड सनफ्लावर ऑयल. सो फ्रेंड्स, यू शुड कंज्यूम मोर आइटम्स फ्रॉम द लिस्ट विच आर कमिंग इन टू द सुइटेबल और कॉम्पेटिबल आइटम्स. And you should try to avoid to the extent possible the items which are coming into non-compatible or non-suitable type of list. Friends, when you avoid taking these unsuitable items, the exaggeration of pit will be minimal. Secondly, I would suggest you to include three items in your routine. Number one is sauf or fennel seed. Number two is coriander. And number three is yeshti madhu. These three Aushadis are those who balances the pit, and you should include them in your routine in order to keep your pit dosha in balance. And lastly, I would suggest you to take extra precaution during the summer, which is Grishma Rutu and Sharad Rutu as per Ayurveda, because in this Rutu, exaggeration of pitta is likely to happen. So with this, I am sure if you follow these guidelines, if you follow this regimen, you will be able to remain healthy and you will be able to lead a nice and pleasant life. In next video, I am going to share you what is the compatible regimen, what is the compatible food for Kapha Prakruti. Till then, stay blessed, stay healthy.